Hey, people have heard of it.
Oh yeah, what's the name?
You can find it on any map.
What's the name of it?
Folks are flocking here from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the hell is Beaumont?
Go right. Interesting name. Is that short for something?
Nope.
The truth is going round about the new kid, and everybody's talking to their blue.
God is love, follow him and never grow. He has made the stars above just to light your way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. like I'm just crazy.
Miss me?
You wish.
Hey there, are you?
Travis, love. Oh my gosh, did I interrupt your weekly poetry club meeting?
Very funny. So, who's that new kid in church?
Oh, this is a classmate. A Chicago transplant with all the charms of his position out there and living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on you.
Hey, Grandson, just. What you do with the preacher's daughter, huh?
Anything
that I want.
Oh yeah, what is she got?
Everything. But I've seen a few movies and this girl really cooks. She taught me some tricks. She can't learn any books. And I'm just got her. She's a devil.
The girl gets around.
She knows what she lacks. I got what you need. It's weather tonight.
Just wait.
We'll go make a move. Yeah, we got sunrise. The girl gets around.
She's not going to do anything.
Excellent!
Yeah, he likes to pretend he's a man with mental. He can't come to test. Don't worry, baby, a secret, stay with me.
What's that?
And he bores me to tears with his fears that his back. People around his reputation strikes. I got blown up, he got the key.
The girl gets around.
She knows what she likes.
She knows what she likes.
I know what she needs.
Yeah.
Wait tonight. We'll both make a move. Yeah, we'll come sunrise. The girl gets around.
I went to the Burger Blast. Your friend suggested I might find you here.
We were just heading over there.
I thought you might be bored.
Evening, Reverend!
Chicago, ain't you?
Perhaps.
My bad. Around here, you push up one and you push back. Next thing you know, you got it.
Two people push it.
Got it?
Got it.
Let me ask you something. Is so man's clothes when you got that hat?
Was that supposed to be some sort of stupid joke?
No, it's a really good joke.
That's it, man. I'm going to
kill you. Oh, please kill me.
Huh?
Kill me. That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I hit this town. Fred McCormick, you are?
Willie Hewitt.
Well, Willie, you guys have anything around here for a good time? Yeah, besides that, you guys got any books?
No.
How about movies?
No.
How about malls? How about?
No. And we do have a bowl of ramen down that interstate, though.
Huh, I really admire you guys. Never know what you guys do here.
Yeah, what do you
do? Nothing!
Fuck you. the funk music?
Never walk when I get lost. Don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down. Say more, you really should. Sit back and chill. I can't stand still.
I can see that.
Call the doctor, he said, son, get her up so you can kill. So I never found relief. Now I've got to move on till I've had my fill. I can't stand still.
Around here we walk.
That's where I come from. Last ever come from. I wish I could stay there.
Getting all righteous. He started eating anything and everything.
drugs, liquor, rock and roll.
Dancing?
You got it.
He convinced the town council's all sin. Just like that, they passed this law.
Wait, Reverend Moore has this kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power.
He is the law.
And how did you guys stand to live like this?
Practice? Years of practice?
It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a town. We could be mugged by people we don't even know.
Yeah, I missed that. I thought living in a small town was gonna be perfect. Like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's heads shaking the minute you cross the line. And there's eyes everywhere.
Oh,
mom. It's a few more minutes.
When my dad's not crazy about me seeing you.
Well, tell him to get used to it.
You tell him.
Fine, I will. Reverend Moore!
Wait. Maybe not at this moment. I hope. No, 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 no. I know. Go! Go home! Hey, Daddy.
Huh?
Are you hungry?
Starving.
Aha!
Don't tell me.
Hayden, the second sonata.
The fourth.
Four, that's right. I guess this kind of music's okay, huh, Daddy?
Meaning?
She's just making a joke, Shock.
More of that vibe. This type of music is uplifting. It doesn't confuse the mind.
Are you, working on your sermon?
I am.
Remember when I was a kid? On Saturdays, I would sit down front and listen to you practice your sermon over and over again.
I do indeed.
And then you'd bow and I'd clap, remember?
Well, you seem to have outgrown that.
Sure. What just happened? Did I say something wrong? Your father's had a difficult day.
But I can speak for myself.
Honey, why don't you set the table? I'm not hungry. Shaw, if you're angry with Ariel, please tell her why.
I'm not angry. I'm concerned.
Then get to the point. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Have you seen what this Chuck Cranston? The last time I walked in on the two
you
of them,
told
the
me.
Boy has a record of arrest by...
And the more you object, the more intrigued she's going to be.
So I should hold my peace?
I do. And I pray every day that her infatuation with Chuck Cranston lasts no longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not an overheated delinquent.
Oh, he most certainly was.
Why, this is not funny.
I'm trying to lighten the mood.
I can't. I'm frightened about where Ariel is. What she's doing.
You can't expect her to just sit at home with us.
Let's stop this conversation right here.
Conversation?
I
seem to have walked in on another one of your sermons.
This has nothing to do with my regret.
Knowing in the winter survive, and die.
Camelot.
Really?
Really.
You know what part I like?
Oh! I like the part where King Arthur and Lancelot fight over Guinevere. It's right after Mordred shows up and yells, I'm the king! I'm the king!
What?
You read a book?
Cliff Notes, it took me
No, the action book is better. There's a knight on horseback seeing a storm in the castle.
Well, we got a guys in overalls riding pickup trucks.
Hey, Willard.
Hi, how y'all doing?
Okay.
Hey, Rosie.
Hi, Willard.
Well, see ya.
Hey, Willard, that's it?
You two are pathetic.
What are you doing, Willard, to have a real conversation?
Well, that's not capable of a real conversation. I kind of like that in a guy. Hey, Ren, how's your new job?
Well, it's already my second day and I haven't been fired yet. What can I eat you ladies?
Diet Coke.
The Hula Burger double patty cheese roll, extra mayo, and an order of fries.
And a Diet Coke.
Ariel, what's your pleasure?
Not a baby.
Oh, world! Ariel!
If Chuck sees you playing with Ariel, you're dead.
She usually doesn't even remember my name.
Well, lad, you look more like a good idiot. You're easy to reach out.
You're always looking for a fight, aren't you?
Mama says it's in my nature.
Willard, shut up and tell me what you know about Ariel.
Well, I know she's kissed a lot.
And
she's on to you like hog on slot.
Get out of here.
Ariel likes trouble, and you've proven to everyone in this town that you are T.R. Bubble.
Come on, I was only teasing him.
That's more than teasing. He runs around in town, and don't tell me that he doesn't curl your toes.
You went out of Beaumont so bad, I bet you memorized bus schedules. You told me you read just to escape out of the world.
I read because I meet guys in books who amaze me.
What about Red?
What about him?
Cute, maybe. But can he really compete with Chuck Cranton, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout slash drug dealer who was recently convicted from a trailer park? I don't think so.
So what's up with you, Gary?
That's me. I think she's pretty and all, but I can never understand what she's saying. That girl's fascinating.
It's because you make her happy.
I wish I could find a guy who'd make the first move.
I wish I could find a guy who, when he kissed me goodnight, would take the toothpick out of his mouth. I wish I could find a guy.
Where have all the good men gone?
My favorite song.
And where are all the guys?
I need it!
Why?
Can
you
just stop
it yourself?
Shut up, Rusty.
Will you be joining these ladies?
What am I? Meet me at 8. What am I? Talking to myself?
I'm sorry for you. Calm down.
Who told you to calm down? Don't you ever tell me what to do. I know what your three friends think of me, and that's bull crap. I'm the best party in this town, baby. Those three dogs might be locked up under a porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. What part of that don't you understand, Chuck?
Ooh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot. Say it again, baby.
Chuck, stop. Get away from me.
I believe the lady said no.
I believe this is none of your business.
Please don't.
Hey, who invited this clown?
I'm sorry. We've never been formally introduced. Run the court.
Get your hand out of my face! Get your hand out of my sight!
Get that corner!
Hey, Chuck! You looking for a fight?
Willen, you're not looking for a shot.
Oh, man, I'm willing!
Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Oh, right. Please, my daddy invented it. And plus, aren't rules meant to be broken?
One day he was just gone. No
or goodbyes or nothing.
I bet you have a lot to say to me.
Hearts.
Mine?
No, I can't.
Tell it to the train. I do.
Some pain and dry some tears. That was the out. See, everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have rules. So heaven, help me with my labor. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven, help me. Oh, heaven, help me.
Thank you.
taking our breaks, taking control. That's what it takes. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. We can face this down right now, right here. We can worry, but the world will say,
yeah. you be living, Thomas?
Yep.
No way. Well, darling, no wonder you're so eager to do some tail shaking over there, huh? Now, where are we?
Hey, cowboy.
Oh, yeah? Well, we all make mistakes.
What was that?
Willard, he was just being friendly.
Yeah?
Look, Sam, it's much too early maybe to get blood on that pretty little shirt of yours. And then, my condolences.
What is he
doing?
Hey, have you got something to say?
Willard, hey, Willard, I know who I came with, okay?
Okay.
And who was there?
I'm going to give you a drink. Red, you want a drink?
Wait, hold on. Who's going to drive? I'll drive.
Sounds good.
Alright, that's two drinks.
I want to dance! I want to dance!
I got three hands. Ben, you know, yeah, yeah.
You should be with it.
Oh. Let me guess. Willard's acting weird again. So it's not just me.
Rusty, you and Willard have been in kindergarten.
Yeah, but Tim's different. This is the first time we've ever gone home together. Maybe we don't travel well.
Rusty, it's just a car ride.
Yeah, but it makes it like the first day, don't you see? The whole way up here, I had to do all the talking. All he could say was, mm-hmm. You know what that means, don't you? My baby's in a panic.
Now, girl, don't make yourself crazy over this.
You okay? You seem nervous.
That's why I'm having a beer. Mama says I can have one beer or one cigarette. So if I have both, I should never come home again.
Willard's useful, Hoffman. Finally go on a date with Rusty.
Whoa, Doc. This is a date? He asked me to go for a ride. He told Ariel to ask Rusty. It's like I'm on a date with you.
And you look so handsome tonight.
Thank you. But you stuck me in the backseat when crazy woman won't stop moving and talking. But the thing is,
Between
you and me,
yeah,
I can't do it. I can't dance.
What?
Did you hear that? Your boyfriend says he can't dance.
Oh, come on, give me time.
But that ain't natural.
It's like riding a bike.
It's as easy as learning to swim.
I can't swim.
Hey, ladies, why don't you say we throw in the pool?
Thank you.
Wendy Joe's to study.
Oh, really? You thought I was just at Wendy Joe's a couple hours ago. He says he left. Rusty. Oh, where's the lottery? Mr. Crimson. Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel. Yes, and that's why I'm surprised that she's not home.
Goodbye. Good night, Mr. Crimson. Please remember there is a curfew.
Yes, sir.
What the heck? The audio's on in the background.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Joe's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
Did you know about this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel, Vi? Now that you know that she's lying to you.
I'm not saying anything until I hear an exclamation from her.
It was Brian when she was running around with Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night with that pumpkin campaign to challenge me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Ha, creeping.
Where were you?
Rusty and Wendy Joe and
I.
We know you weren't at Wendy Joe's.
I can't believe you guys are checking up on me.
Honey, how do we know if you're not sick or hurt?
I'm concerned for your well-being.
Oh yeah? Well, if you're so concerned, then how come you're never concerned about what I have to say or what I have to feel? But the moment I walk out the door, wham, you're suddenly the concerned parent.
Shush, she doesn't mean that.
Stop inside. She has to start answering for herself.
Well, I don't know what any of this bound to. Her will listen to me anymore than you listen to her.
Shush!
actually speaking in front of the town council, so don't mock me. Now,
do that last part again.
Members of the council, dancing is not a crime.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Ever since the dawn of time, everybody has a right to howl at the moon and to move all night. When folks who traveled back before the Bible, they were liable to dance when the crops came in, or they would pull out all the stops when the earth would spin, or maybe paid a battle win. So they would dance. Anytime they had a chance, no matter the season or circumstance, they'd find any reason to have a party in the pants. So it's doing like they get to dance, dance, dance.
You said party in your pants? Are you out of your mind?
Girls!
Friend,
I'm not saying that's bad. It's just that it's not good.
Then what am I supposed to do? Party pre-rated 9 times.
You're going to be speaking in front of Reverend Moore and some of those stubbornest people in this town.
We are got plenty of people boiling mad.
Yeah, folks are getting sad, and they're not picking yours.
Who am I kidding? This whole thing has already gotten way out of hand. Maybe I ought to just forget it.
Whoa! Buddy, you don't mean to discourage you.
After all the posters we painted, all the wires we passed out,
everybody had school was climbing the wall.
So you just need to rethink your approach. Now, Mama says.
Oh, Mama again!
Guys, everything I ever learned gets me through the worst. I learned at my mama's knees. Many times I've turned around, I turn to mama first. And you'd be wise to memorize what mama says to me. Now mama ain't been wrong yet, and I'm gonna prove. Mama says, don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now who can argue with that? Mama says, don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you ride up the mountain,
can't back down.
Now, Rand, you haven't had the pleasure of meeting my mama, but these girls have them. Come on, help me out, ladies.
Mama says,
don't use a coffee lying down a minute. Don't even give it a knock.
It's a mess, Mama says.
Never eat anything that's bigger than your head. Is she a whiz or what?
Oh, yes.
The Mama says, it doesn't matter. If you're a king or you're a clown, once you climb up a mountain, you can't back down. Once you climb up a mountain, you can't back down. Now, Mom makes a lot of sense if you know how to listen. She's clear and concise.
She's concise.
Daddy says, I love her son, but she's got mama's blessing. I said, hey, it's free advice. What do you expect at that price?
Maybe your mama ought to give us a speech.
Heck no, everyone thinks mama's great. But the point is, she's got some good ideas. Now hear me out.
Mama says,
what you believe in is all you really own. And I believe that she's right.
Mama says,
if you got doubts, boy, you're not alone. Just be directed by. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you drive a hard bargain or drive around town. Once you ride up a mountain, what that's about. Mama says, Don't chew on tin foil. Unless you like that feeling. Somehow she figured that out. And mama says it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you travel a mountain, remember boy, everyone's counting on you. Once you
I swear that I could see.
are causing it a whole lot. And I still don't even know what I'm saying to town council.
Never mind. We're gonna need this.
The Holy Bible?
I'm actually pages.
Whoa, where did you find all these passages?
Are you kidding me?
Thanks.
Times people dance for many reasons. woman, we do not need to
excuse me, driver. Are we told in Psalm 149 to praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song? Let them praise the name of the dance. And it was King David. King David who read God and Samuel. And what did David do?
Dance.
What did David do? David danced before the Lord all his might, leaping and dancing before the Lord. Leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes assures us that there is a time to every purpose under heaven. A time to laugh, and a time to mourn. A time to weep, and a time to dance. There was a time for this law, but not anymore. That's how it was in the beginning. That's how it's always been. That's how it should be now. Thank you.
McCormick.
Reverend.
It's late.
Really? I'm quite awake. Can I ask you a question?
And I couldn't wait until morning?
No question, I promise. For tonight's meeting, did you tell the council how to vote?
We discussed the issue, of course.
But did you tell them how to vote?
Reverend, this is more than a question of a town.
Did you? Reverend Moore, I know what this town is.
No, I don't think you do. Because if you did, you wouldn't have provoked your classmates into reopening the wounds we have just
healed. Those wounds are not healed. If they were, people wouldn't be glaring at me on the sidewalk. They wouldn't be snubbing my mom at the market. They wouldn't be boycotting my uncle's business. And you wouldn't be fixing the town council.
I thought it was time to put an end to this nonsense.
Nonsense? All I say is who's up for a little dancing? And all this town can think about is a Patani Bridge and four kids.
Mr. McCormick!
And I know your son was wonderful. And I'm real sorry for that. But, look, shutting out the world isn't working.
I'm sure you have all the answers.
I did.
And you're gonna set me straight. How many of you do you know what I've been through? You don't have a clue.
Reverend, if I can only.
You know what? Good night, Mr. McCormick.
Please.
Mr. McCormick, I would like to be alone.
Sir, you already are. We both are. You and me. And although people say they understand, they really don't. stop every day and ask yourself why? I do. I wonder, why my dad? Is this something I do? Bring him back. I can't. But I don't have to tell you. You already know.
Yes, I do.
And although I came to this town upset and angry, I hope real good to pick up some books. I'm just so tired of looking back, and I can't stand still.
Okay.
I'm gonna go now. I know you're gonna have to do what you have to do about the dance and all, but thank you for listening.
Ren. I'm sorry your father won't ever get to know you.
Thank you, Reverend.
As your minister, it is my duty to make sure that you are finding the joy in your lives. Last night that I realized that I haven't been doing that. After all, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago when the lives of 4 young people ended off the Tawny Bridge. Everyone lost someone that night. A child, a neighbor, a friend. We lost our son. Ariel lost her brother. Now, somehow I got into my head that my loss was the greatest, that my pain was the deepest, and that someone much younger than I came to me and showed me how tightly I'd been holding on to that memory. A memory that has weighed me down as surely as a great stone. And I did something I haven't done in a very long time. I laid down my burden. It was a terrifying moment. It was exhilarating. This morning, I would like to offer you the same opportunity. The senior class of Beaumont High School has asked permission to throw a dance. Ren, I think that might be a good idea. Please join me in asking our Lord to guide and protect our children. You are dismissed.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
roll the legs up and duck.
I love where this is going.
Your mom can make one of those croissants.
Yes.
Woman!
You're painting a picture for me, aren't you? All I see is a rusty chair that smells bad, you in a taped up brown suit, and me, wearing a poor side made of God knows what.
What do you think?
Will there be a dance next time?
Yes, ma'am. You wanna?
Well, I would love to!
Thank you. gift made by the mother of one of our cast members to leave, Mr. Ashton, or whatever he is. So we'd like to bring up Mr. Gonzalez to the center.
So much for just the arts program as well and everything, the struggle that is what we're dealing with in Arizona. So thank you guys for coming out and supporting us. I also want to give a quick shout out to some people who are here and not here. Some of my colleagues from the district, Mr. Jeff Spence from Verado, Mr. Corey Beal at Desert Edge, and Ms. Kim LaGuardia at Millennium. They are great support to us. I think Mr. Corey Beal is out in the audience now, so he rocks there. Of a lot of our seniors here at Agua Fria. Their journey with us here from freshmen up to seniors and some of us that just joined us here. So I would actually like to invite all of our seniors for their final bow. Thank you guys once again. You guys have a great night.